Hello everybody, my name is Zohir Chaudhary and we'll talk about non-ionizing radiation. So non-ionizing radiation, what is it? Radiation that has enough energy to move atoms in a molecule around or cause them to vibrate but not enough to move electrons is known as non-ionizing radiation. Examples of non-ionizing radiations are extremely low frequency radiation, ELF, those that are in power lines, AM, FM radio station, TV stations, as well as radio waves, microwave radiation, infrared radiation, as well as radiation from visible light coming from the sun, and finally ultraviolet radiation, UVA, UVB, or UVC are examples of non-ionizing radiation. Ultraviolet radiation, UVR, is one that we'll talk about today, as well as radio frequency coming from cell phone. So ultraviolet radiation is part of the electromagnetic spectrum emitted by the sun and is further subdivided into UVA, UVB, and UVC. And UVC is the one that would be most damaging in the upper atmosphere. However, all of UVC is absorbed by the atmosphere. So at ground level, the one that is most harmful is actually UVB, as I'll see in our next slide. So by ultraviolet radiation A, B, and C, both comes from outer space from the sun, but the atmosphere absorbs all of UVC, and then the ozone layer absorbs most of UVB, but a little bit of UVB still filters into the ground, which causes UV damage. And then UVA gets filtered, most of it to the atmosphere, some of it goes into the ground, and this is needed to produce vitamin D in skin cells. Effects of UV radiation essentially are temporary conditions such as burns and temporary blindness. Long-term conditions are photoaging of the skin, non-melanoma skin cancer, malignant melanoma, retinal damage, as well as lens opacity. In here, we can see a study that was done in three locations. One location is in Barrow, Alaska, a high-latitude location. A mid-latitude location in San Diego, California, 32 degree north latitude, and then in the southern hemisphere, a high latitude, but in the southern hemisphere, Palmer, Antarctica. As you can see in here, this green location, which is in San Diego, is expected to have more UV exposure throughout the season. The UV index would be higher in San Diego because the sun shines more. And similar would happen to equatorial areas that are closer to the equator. On the other hand, in Barrow, Alaska, you can see that UV exposure is much lower. However, in Palmer, Antarctica, which is in the southern hemisphere, UV exposure is much higher, and in some cases much higher than San Diego as well, especially in the spring. And this is due to the ozone hole that many of you might have heard. The ozone has had a hole starting from the late 70s, early 80s when it was discovered, and since then it has been enlarging, and now slowly it is repairing. It is estimated by 2050 the ozone hole will be repaired all over again. But meanwhile, if you live in Alaska, expect high UV radiation, especially in the summertime, in the springtime. Radio frequency radiation and cell phones, it's another concern. Cell phones work because of the radio frequency that gets emitted from the base tower into the cell phone to transfer data and voice. However, as you hold the cell phone close to your body, the exposure to non-ionizing radiation is evident. And because of the very high usage of cell phone, it is extremely important to understand the health effects of this non-ionizing type of radiation that it may have on tissues. So IARC has looked at multiple studies, which is something that you must look at. And IARC has classified radiation from cell phones to be possibly carcinogenic to humans, 2B. And the various classification of IARC, which is an agency under the United Nations located in France, are expressed in here, and cell phone has been classified as a 2B types of radiation. However, this is subject of a long, still a lot of research and study, and I highly recommend that you actually use the internet to look at the publication from IARC, which was released in 2011, the press release 2011, that talks about radio frequency and its health effects. So quick concept check. IARC classifies radio frequency radiation as group 1. False. It's 2B. All right. Thank you.